welcome to the webinar on PD monitoring in rotary machines. Today, your host will be engineer Lorenzo Paschini, who will be sharing with you some of the knowledge obtained in his many years as a service engineer working for Techimp Altanova. My name is Andrei Shepchich, and I will be moderating the webinar. So without any further ado, Lorenzo, take it away.
Thank you, Andrei, and welcome to the introduction to Partial Discharge Diagnostic on Rotating Machines webinar. I'm Lorenzo Paschini, service engineer, senior service engineer at Techimp Altanova Group Company, a company based in Italy, but present worldwide. That's what we're going to, let's say, speak about today. We'll start speaking about generic partial discharge and rotating machine topics. We will then go into the PD sensors for rotating machines. We will see the differences between online tests versus offline tests for PD measurements. We will give a brief overview of what are the typical PD phenomena. We will see one of the main topics in this kind of job, that is denoising the signal and identify crosstalks. Then we will go through PD analysis. And finally, we will present a short list of the key products and services for rotating machine PD tests. Let's start with some definition. The definition that we have for partial discharge is that is suggested from EAC. It's a localized electrical discharge that only partially bridges the insulation between conductors and which can or cannot occur to adjacent to a conductor. Similar definition is given from the IEEE. And basically, what we need to know from partial discharge is that is a effect due to a defect in the insulation that is activated by electrical stress, voltage stress. How do we study the PD phenomena? We study PD phenomena through the phase-resolved partial discharge pattern, normally known as PRPD pattern, where we save all the information of thousands of PD pulses recorded for each second, and we plot them correlated with the phase angle. On the top here, we have an historic Lissajous visualization of partial discharge, and on the bottom, a more modern visualization of partial discharge. We can have on the vertical axis the PD pulse amplitude, while on the horizontal axis, we have the phase angle when the PD occurs. We can have in literature some guides and standards for rotating machine testings. We have, for example, the EAC 63427 part 2 related to online partial discharge measurement. We have the IEEE 1434, and we have also the SIGRAE 258 application of online PD tests to rotating machines. What are the what can we say about the sensor to record partial discharge in rotating machine? We will see how we detect the signal. We will see what are the sensor's typologies, the requirements of such sensor, and the positioning of the sensor. In the end, signal and safety. How do we detect the signal? Basically, PD phenomena generates signals that are sources of high-frequency electromagnetic signals and irradiated signals as well. So we can force the conducted signal to pass across our sensor, or we can try to measure this sensor with an antenna or something different. Different sensor will always give us different output, different sensitivity, and they can provide or not the synchronization signal. Most popular sensors are the capacitive couplers. Those are connected normally to the rotating machine connection, and the signal is measured or across measuring impedance as a voltage drop, or with an high-frequency current transformer. In the end, there is also another solution, that is with antenna sensor. Those have to be installed into the stator, and they will pick up the irradiated signals. Obviously, three different sensors will give us different parameters, different capabilities. If we start about the sensitivity, the capacitive sensor that picks up a conducted signal is characterized by the very high sensitivity. While the capacitive sensor with an HFCT has a lower quality signal information, while the antennas, they have a very good sensitivity locally, but we need, let's say, many of them to have a proper coverage of the stator windings. The installation of the sensor in capacitive and capacitive which with HFCT sensor, it's a medium effort, while with to install antennas, it's a very high effort because we have to install something inside our stator. The safety characterized by the different sensor is a medium for the capacitive because we always have a conducted signal going to the acquisition unit. When we have a capacitive with HFCT sensor, it's very high safety because the signal is inducted, and with antenna the safety is high as well because it's an irradiated signal. One very important topic from my point of view as a testing engineer is the synchronization signal presence. As I told you in the first slide, we build the PD data in the PRPD pattern, phase resolve PD pattern. In order to have the phase resolution, we need to have a synchronization signal that is a voltage signal directly correlated to the applied voltage to the insulation. This signal is made available with the capacitive couplers, but we don't have such signal when we have sensor with the capacitive coupler plus an HFCT or antennas. The coupling principle is a conducted signal for capacitive sensor, inducted signal for capacitive sensor with an high frequency current transformer, and radiated signal with antennas. Now, let's see what are the sensor requirements. Since the permanent sensor will be installed in a very high, let's say, in a very critical environment, whenever we want to install the sensor, we must be sure that it's safe and it's not adding any risk of failure to our asset. So we have a very stressful type test. In the picture, there is a impulsive test layout for our sensor. Each sensor is subjected 3 times the rated voltage for a withstand test, and each sensor shall be free of partial discharge at the rated voltage after a pre-stress session. In this case, for example, we have even a higher level of safety. We also test our sensor and we mark them with the different, let's say, trademarks, A++, in order to, let's say, have a very high voltage stress acceptable for the sensor. In the end, the capacitance and the voltage ratio shall be tested with the very small tolerance values. Now, sensor positioning. For the same reason, we installed this sensor in a very, let's say, particular environment. And normally, we just install them once in a lifetime. We have to make sure everything is made properly. Our sensor shall not have magnetic bars. I mean, they shall not have magnetic bars. We should have a PD sensor that does not reduce the insulation capabilities of the stator and of the bus bar section. We should have sensors those are okay with the ongoing temperature and vibration stress. And in the end, very important, we should make a proper installation with proper spacing, avoiding corona and surface PD that would affect the PD measurement for the rotating machine. And we have discussed about the PD sensor installation. Now, obviously, we cannot exceed directly this PD sensor since they are in a very particular environment. The signals from the sensor shall be carried outside with proper conduit and trunks, and the signal shall be made available at an external derivation box. Our derivation box, they provide actually 2 things. One is the synchronization signal from one of the phases, and they introduce safety for the acquisition unit and the operator. There are some, let's say, voltage control in the derivation box in order to work in a very safe condition. This particular aspect is important practically to have the chance to make the test without special permits, without special working risk assessment, and making us, giving us the chance to test the generator whenever we want without big problems. Now, let's give a quick look at online test versus offline test topic. First, we will present a typical PD offline test layout and with its characteristic, and a PD online test layout. Then we'll see a technical comparison, so the data quality of these two solutions, and a practical comparison. In offline PD test, we normally have an outage, so we have accessibility to the windings directly. We can install even temporary our capacitive coupler. We will inject the voltage in one of the coil, and we will measure one by one with a portable instrument. What are the technical aspects we have to keep in mind when choosing to do an offline test? The voltage stress here is face to ground, and it's constant along the wall winding. We don't have any face-to-face stress, and we have the very same voltage stress applied to all the winding. While normally working condition, we have a, let's say, variable voltage stress along the winding. Then the generator or the motor is motionless, steady, and there are no temperature changes during the test. Let's say not significant temperature changes during the test. Also, we are not taking into account the mechanical behavior of the stator. We don't have vibration. And in this case, we have to keep in mind that one good thing is that if we can open the start point of the generator, we can test phase by phase. These give us chance to identify better the source and to have a more, let's say, clear comparison between the different phases. The voltage source shall be for sure free of any PD signal or high frequency signal in order to have a good measurement. One very practical aspect is that we can ramp up and down the voltage stress in order to evaluate PD inception voltage and PD exception voltage. Very classical parameters normally used during testing, laboratory testing. Is it also possible to overstress the insulation? We don't have any limit to the voltage we apply. We can go over the rated voltage of the insulation and see what is the behavior of the electrical insulation system. Then we see something about the online PD test. I'm considering with online PD test a running generator with a permanently installed sensor. Those are available from a derivation box and can be measured with a portable kit. The technical aspects to be taken into account is that in this case, the electrical stress is the routine stress of the winding, the same electrical stress that is always applied to the winding. We can take advantage in some cases, as the standard suggests us, to different load parameters and different temperature parameters for the PD analysis. On the negative side, since we are testing all the phases together and they are all connected to the same grounding systems, we can have signals from one phase flowing into the sensor of the other phases, giving us the so-called crosstalks effect. We shall take care during the analysis to identify properly these signals and to match each signal with its phase. With the online test, we may have very easily some external disturbances. Those may be related to the electronics of the generator, to the ongoing activities nearby, but everything is connected, so we can have this kind of disturbances. Another good thing that we can do with the online PD test is that we can perform simultaneously on the three phases the PD test, and we can take advantage of the different phase shifts between the phases to make the analysis. In the end, one very good thing about online testing is that, as a hypothesis, we have the permanent sensor installed. And that's a very key point, because we will have the same sensitivity along the lifetime of the generator, since we are using always the same sensors. Last but not least, the PD test can always be performed in a very safe condition. Now, let's make a short technical comparison. Permanent sensor required. In offline, we don't need them. We can bring our own sensor and install it temporarily. In online, if we don't have any permanent sensor, the measurement will be impossible. We don't have any crosstalk effect in offline testing, while we have this kind of effect in online testing. But we don't have the real electrical stress during offline tests. That's something that we, of course, have in online tests. The correlation of the historic data, is it very easy to do with the online test, because it only depends on the acquisition unit. If we are using the same acquisition unit, we will have the same readings. On the offline test, we may have different sensor, different acquisition unit, especially if this job is outsourced to third companies. 1 year, we can have one company coming with the KIMP, instrument and sensor. The other year, somebody else can come with another instrument, and the correlation can be hard to do. Continuity is a very key point when study rotating machine data historically. The team stress is not present in offline tests. We only have electrical stress. Instead, in online tests, we have aging, we have thermal, we have mechanical stress, and so on. Under a very, let's say, low-level practical comparison, we can say that the offline test has a higher price. We need to bring more assets in the field to make the test. We need to make an outage, while during the online test, it's just about the service job. The customer effort for the offline test is high because we need an outage, we need support, we need to prepare a risk assessment, and so on. On the online test, it was low, but I kept high, sorry for that, consider low. I will try to fix it before we send to you the presentation. Outage required for offline test, obviously, is yes, because we cannot put our hands there without outage. In online, we don't need any outage. PD sensor for offline tests are brought by service company. Instead, in online test, we need to have the sensor, and we also need to study the sensor compatibility between acquisition unit and sensor. On the safety point of view, the offline test is obviously more hazardous. We introduce a new voltage generator. We are with open machine. It's not so safe. From the stress point of view, it's a particular discussion, because with offline test, we can apply different voltage level. While with the online test, we will have only the electrical stress that is fixed, but we will have the normal cases of temperature and load changes stress. Operation department shall be involved during offline test. Of course, yes, because we need outage and all these safety issues. With online test, it's very easy. We just need a simple permit to work. Material required when we go offline, we need the HP source, the sensor, the PD, the sensor for the PD, and the acquisition unit. In online testing, we only need the acquisition unit that will be connected to the sensor.